What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? You know, it's your boy Solace, man. Issa Go checking in with my motherfucking niggas, man. All my global niggas, man. I ain't talked to y'all in a minute, man. You know what the fuck it is, baby. You know the goddamn vibes, man. Glad to be checking back in with y'all, man. Talking to my goddamn people around the world, man. All my family. It's been a long 10 years with y'all, man. We done put out so much music since the Indigo's days. You know what I mean? Going through pandemics. A lot of y'all is a lot older. I love seeing y'all on the street and niggas telling me like, yeah, bro, I've been with you since 16. I'm 23 now. I love that, man. Like, I've gotten a lot older, you know what I mean? A lot of new opinions and views and emotional trials and tribulations and ups and downs and lots going on over the past years, you know what I mean? I know the same for y'all. So we finally got Tempus out, man. You know what I mean? Tempus 2, you know what I mean? That was just a gift to the homies. I want to apologize. I've been gone for 2 years just finding out a lot by myself. Went through a crazy breakup that sent me spiraling crazy, man. And just been dealing with a lot of bullshit. Life's been good, but, you know, growing up and relationships and all that type of stuff, like, it really sets in. So I just been doing a lot of growth mentally, spiritually, emotionally, you know what I mean? And I'm in a really good space now since the last time I did a podcast. And so, yeah, we here now. Just want to apologize to y'all, all of y'all around the world that's fans that feel like we haven't been doing much. Just know it's my fault. It's not AK fault. It's really my fault. I've been doing a lot of growing. And now I'm ready to, like, you know what I mean, come back and do this music shit on a stronger level. And I got a lot of plans for 2023. Of course, we got the new Underachiever music coming. We got to make a new album. I know some of you niggas is like, are they beefing? No, absolutely not. Me and Ock are still best friends. I just kind of been not making music. I've been like focused on growing and coming up with plans for the future. He's ready. So we got a bunch of stuff coming. New album, new world tour, new music videos, new everything is going to come. Definitely have him on here sometime. I'm definitely going to start be dropping music under Solace. I'll probably just keep Issa Gold to Tempus. Don't quote me on that, but I want to start dropping under a new moniker that you guys know I came up with like 6 years ago. So Tempus was just like a treat before that, but I'm working on Pressure right now, which is going to be really good. Yeah, Pressure's going to be like a combination of mad different shit. You know what I mean? Trying to bring in all the different styles. You know, I ain't never seen myself as a solo artist. So like being a solo artist and evolving through that, I feel like a baby. Like I just started. A lot of you know that I came to music late, so this is a whole new process. So just developing a sound and like not trying to like follow other sounds. You know, I'm always trying to keep it unique and develop like my own sound in some way. That's why with Tempus, I went so experimental. With Tempus 2, which I'll talk about a lot more on this one, that was more straightforward rap. So it was just a fun project to write. After Tempus being such an emotional project, to be able to just freely write and like relearn writing and finding a love for writing was Tempus 2. That's why it's called Mirrors. It was like me kind of making music that like reflected in people in like a positive way, in the sense of like, I feel like music is a mirror, and like we hear music and we hear lyrics and we like put ourselves inside of those shoes and we change it to names. Like I might make a song talking about Flatbush and being in the staircase, but you guys might hear that and transfer that into a street that's in your neighborhood and like a place where you and your friends hung out. And like for a long time with writing music, it was hard for me to write music that people couldn't relate to. Like every line had to be relatable at a point. And being with Chuck Strangers and like listening to like a lot more rap music, I started to learn how to get comfortable and being a lot more personable in the music. And Tempus 1 was the first time I like tried that, to be as personal as I can, because I knew that people would see themselves in it. And while writing Tempus 1, I was like, wow, this is like a mirror. So Tempus 2 was basically playing more on that, but in an even more fun way. And so, like, I had a lot of fun writing that. And Precious is going to be different. It's going to I think I finally found the sound I'm going for and how to, like, combine all the different sounds. So that's going to be, like, my... That's why I want to change my name for it, because it's, like, I feel like I fell into my own. And I think I'll still release music under Issa Gold, but I feel like...
You know what I mean? Sometimes you got to switch it up. Like, my nigga 2 Chainz did, you know what I mean? He came back Titty Boy. You know what I mean? Hold on. Spark my shit, my niggas. You niggas not smoking dope, which we gonna talk about too, but hold on. Yeah, I mean, I feel like I've come into my own musically now. You know what I mean? The first 10 years was me figuring it out, because I came to music mad late. You niggas know the story, so that's the plan. Solace for the solo, Issa Gold for the UA. So Tempus is a special project because it's like the solidification of the Issa Gold. You know what I mean? If you remember when I originally, some of y'all gonna remember, but when I originally started talking about Tempus, it was originally gonna come out under Solace. You could pull that up. That was like 2016. I was like, yep, new project, Tempus, Solace. But I just ain't do it, but I'm ready to do it for this next one, Pressure. But with UA, we got a project coming. I'm not even dropped it. I think it's going to be called Vices and Virtues. That's a little, yeah, I mean, for y'all, but that shit is going to be good. We working on it. Hopefully drop some singles soon. Thinking about trying to get something out really soon, but I ain't going to put no date on it. But, yeah, that's coming. But, yeah, with the Wee Shot, I was going to talk to y'all niggas about, it's like, next year I'm trying to, yeah, I got a plan for niggas. Like, I feel like, right now, all right, so like, being free thinkers the way that we are, like, all the people that listen to our music, all of us growing up together and shit, like, when you a free thinker, what you lack is structure. And that's the one thing that I've found in religion that is a value, of, along with a lot of other things, but the main thing is that it provides for the people who follow their religions, like, strictly a level of structure that is missing from, like, people who are free thinkers, because you almost are like an anarchist where you have no rules. You know what I mean? You're just, you got your little ideas you have or ideology that you believe in. Oh yeah, think this way and do this type of thing and treat people this way, et cetera, et cetera. But without that structure, especially like a 9-to-5, especially if you're in school, especially if you're in entertainment or arts, or like it's not forced onto, you don't have kids, et cetera, et cetera. It's hard to like enjoy your vices while still chasing like the aspirations, the dream that you might have. You know what I mean? And I know a lot of y'all gonna know what I'm talking about. But it's like, I've been realizing as I've been thinking of like sobriety and shit like that, which is pretty fire, you know what I mean? It's like, I feel like it's more moderation. And like, niggas gotta start developing schedules and being on some like, almost having a 9-to-5 and like keeping your like usage of the different substances that you use, from weed, alcohol, whatever, psychedelics, whatever type shit, to like a moderation level instead of just going sober. I know mad y'all niggas is trying to do that, and the battle is hard, because it's like, nigga, I ain't trying to just go sober, nigga, because I like smoking dope and getting high. I don't think ain't nothing wrong with that shit. But in the same breath, we all know how like those types of things can be debilitating to your dreams and aspirations. You know what I mean? And like, I go through that shit too. I probably would have put out 13 albums. You know what I mean? But I was dealing with a lot of other shit besides just that. But I think you know what I'm talking about. So I'm trying to like change the way we think about like using these substances that we enjoy and like keeping them at bay, like instead of like the addiction part. And I know that's probably hard, but I'm trying to run like an experiment almost and shit, like on myself type shit. Like the book that I've been writing, I'm still about 40,000 words into it, but I've been changing what it's going to be about. It's going to be about like this like idea that I have for how to like properly, not properly, but a different perspective on straight edge culture, where it's like not fully sober, but like, nigga, yeah, I smoke weed only during this hour during the day, and the rest of the day you doing X, Y, and Z, whatever the other like type shit that you're trying to accomplish. Or I only do this on the weekends, or like, yeah, I like to do my little MDMA, but on Saturdays, you know what I mean? Like keeping your shit like completely in taxed so that you follow on a strict schedule during the days and your whole life is scheduled out and you have structure, because that's what's lacking from the free minds is structure. You meet the most beautiful minds, but niggas shit ain't advancing and they ain't doing shit because niggas ain't got no structure. You know what I mean? Like, all the shit that we was able to build was because we had a structure. You know what I mean? Whether that's you in the studio from 9 to 5, or you doing your artwork from 9 to 5, or you got your shit set up where you do this, that, this, this, this. But when niggas just smoke dope, I don't care what niggas say. I heard Wiz say that the other day. And Wiz is funny. He's the person I use as an example of, like, a nigga that do smoke weed and is ultra productive. But niggas know most niggas ain't. We definitely make you lazy, you know what I mean? And, like, so that's one of the plans for next year, is like coming up with this whole moderation plan, put myself to the test, and then sharing it with y'all through podcasts and shit like that. Like, start talking about the, like, how, what I'm going through, because y'all niggas know I smoke dope and I love drinking liquor, and there's other substances that I like that I indulge in still. I'm in LA, so I want to get it under control as well, to be able to like share that type shit with my niggas, you know what I mean? So, like, that's one of the things I'm looking at for next year. Pressure for sure, you know what I mean? Moderation, I ain't come up with a name for it, but, like, taking from the straight edge culture, which is, straight edge culture is, like, niggas back in the day, they had, like, this group of people that were, like, punk niggas who, like, ain't do no drug. They were straight edge. They were kind of bad, but there's things to be stolen from the, from it, not stolen, but borrowed. They used to wear the triple X shit. That meant straight edge, but might do triple V's or something. You know what I mean? But yeah, so with Tempus 2, talk about that shit a little bit, my nigga. We bouncing around, you know what I mean? That shit was, I love all those songs. I think I like it better than Tempus 1. Tempus 1 was a heartache to make. This was so much fun. It was such a release. I really was going to call it Friends or like For Fun, I swear, because it was so much fun making. My favorite show in there is Crawling, which, that song is about, like, because for the past year, like, after I got out of this crazy breakup, I started to, like, go outside, because I was, like, an inside introverted nigga this whole time. Like, I was not outside at all. Going to parties, or, like, interacting with people, networking, I didn't believe in none of that shit. I was just inside for, like, 9 years this whole time. And when I went through the breakup, I started to, like, go outside more. I met Matt, new friends, and other people, and it was important for me because you know, you lose your confidence and like your identity after like a breakup like that. And yeah, I lost myself for like a while for the past year. So if y'all niggas was wondering where I was at, that's where I was the first year after the breakup. The second year, you guys probably, if you follow me online, was seeing I was partying more, I was outside, I was networking with people, I was meeting new friends, I was, and it was very important. But that song Crawling is kind of about the whole experience of like the breakup and like kind of the nighttime and like my experience with the nighttime. You know, it's like we push forward, wish for new mornings, watch the night office, made it home crawling whole time. I felt like I was walking, you know, the nights you washed, you felt like you was walking, you were really crawling, you know what I mean? Yeah, I mean, you go take that shower, wash the night off of you, you know what I mean? Like, that whole song, if you listen to that one, it's about that. And then the second verse is about, like, relationships and, like that's why that verse came out that way. And then Indulge was, I've been spending a lot of time in Texas with my bro, Joaquin. And, yeah, I've been having a lot of fun there. Indulge, Crawling, and the one after is my, like, three favorites right there. But I love LaMelo so much. I love Swish. Oh, man. I had so much fun writing this one. But Crawling is one I hope to, like, shoot a video to, maybe, or something like that. But I really don't be too much into the videos. I be trying to make music. Just drop it. Make music. Drop it. But yeah, now I've been in L.A., you know, for probably like going on 10 years now next year, almost as long as the career with UA. But I'm just really excited to get back to making music, and the plans for the moderation thing, and talk more about addiction, how bad it is, and even kind of showing how bad weed is. I think there's so much good information out there about weed, but niggas don't really be talking about the dark side. Niggas is addicted. Niggas can't do shit. You know the niggas I'm talking about. I ain't even just talking. I'm talking about me fully. You niggas see, I was able to build a career, so I do something right. But I could have done more. But a lot of my friends have been held back by just smoking pot, smoking dope, chilling, kicking it. Even though they have beautiful minds, so that's really important for me to start moving towards that with just not weed, but with all substances. You know what I mean? Cause, you know, I was telling niggas do substances for years. It's like, nah, we got to upgrade that into like a new way of thinking. Then we got. What else you got going on? Overland Hills. I'm trying to turn that into like a whole thing. Like, I kind of dropped the ball with that, but that's about to be like my main Instagram where I'm going to be on most of the time. And like, I'm trying to like really make it some exclusive shit where I'm providing like as much shit as I can about shit, talking to niggas. You know what I mean? Doing more podcasts. You know what I mean? Like, finishing a lot more of these ideas, running it through that. That's like really important to me. Haven't really been using it because of everything I've been telling y'all, growing myself mentally, spiritually, emotionally, through the breakup, meeting new friends, networking, learning myself musically, growing as a musician. Because I did give niggas both Tempuses in those 2 years, which is good. But yeah, that's been kind of why I've been off the map. And it's kind of hard adjusting to like the new shit, like, yeah, I mean, I'm like an old man now, my niggas. I don't even know how to use nothing. I don't know how to make a TikTok. Like, literally, I don't know how to upload one. Like, forget even, like, making a dance. Like, I don't know how to do that. I don't know how to make reels, really. Like, someone got to send me through all that shit. I'm, like, kind of outdated with, like, the socials, and it's so important right now. When we first came out, it was like, nigga, you drop an album, some videos a year, you're lit. Now you got to, like, drop 5 albums. And it takes away a little bit from the creativity, but it just, you have to upgrade the way you create, pretty much, into like not having to sacrifice quality for quantity, because I can't do that. Like, I need it, both of them, to be up there. And so I got to adjust to that, using the online more. Like, I went live like 4 times in my life. Like, I should be live. I should be twitching and all that dumb shit to connect to the fans. That's really what brought me to music, like, was connecting to not the fans, but like to people, and like building this network of people who are like like-minded niggas who like cool ignorant shit, but also like smart shit and are ambitious and have dreams, but also like being degenerates and camping, like that duality that I always speak about. Like, that's not important to me. So it's like, I want to do more shit where I'm talking to niggas and getting opinions from niggas and building that network of niggas who like are similar. Because I remember a friend told me before, he was like, you a bad leader. He was right. Because, like, I just disappear, you know. And I feel a responsibility to people who, like, listen to our music or, like, follow us or, like, agree with, like, the perspective that we have. And they're growing and developing more perspectives outside of the ones that even we got. Like, I'm sure a lot of y'all have so much to say and have evolved outside of maybe talking to me 5 years ago or 10 years ago. The same with me. I don't got the same opinions or ideas from since then, but yeah, that's pretty much what's been going on. Just a little catch up right here. You know what I mean? We got new shit coming next year. Overlandhills.com, overland/hills.com. We got vinyls and CDs and all that shit on there right now. You go over there and cop that. You know what I mean? Support the Overland Hills for the holidays. And yeah, hopefully make some more of these really soon. But yeah, I'm going to get this one up ASAP. Love y'all niggas, man. Thanks for always being around for us and supporting us. Listen to the music. Loving the shit we do. We love y'all. And yeah, I'm going to holler at y'all niggas, man.